गांधी नेशनल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी प्रेजेंट्स अ प्रोग्राम फूड एंड ड्रग्स। इन टुडेज इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड सोसाइटी विद ग्रोइंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ पोल्यूशन पीपल आर फॉलिंग सिक मोर ऑफन। एज सच वी कैरी एंटीबायोटिक्स विद अस व्हाइल ट्रैवलिंग एंड इवन स्टोर देम इन आवर हाउसेस फॉर इमरजेंसी। इट्स नॉट बैड टू टेक दीज प्रिकॉशंस, बट इफ यू डू नॉट नो the right food and drug combination, it can cause a number of harmful effects, even death. In this program, we introduce you to Sanjay, BA final year student who has recently fallen sick and is failing to recover. Meanwhile, Sanjay's cousins Sadhna and Rashmi, final year MBBS students, call on him to inquire about his failing health. Now over to Sanjay, Rashmi and Sadhna.
Hello Sanjay, Rashmi and I heard that you are not feeling well. How are you feeling now?
Hello Sadhna and Rashmi, it's really nice to have you here. Regarding health, don't ask me anything. Feeling very sickly and weak.
I think you are not taking enough food.
No, mother started giving me more nutritious food ever since I had fallen sick. In fact, I started taking a glass of milk 3 times a day.
I see. Now I get you. It seems you don't know the right combination of food and drugs. You see, Sanjay, some foods and drugs are the best of friends. They get along famously. But did you know that some food and drugs just do not mix together? Their mental dislike can cause a number of harmful effects, even death. What do you say, Rashmi?
Of course. The classical example of a food-drug interaction is that of the well-known antibiotic tetracycline with milk. Milk and milk products contain calcium, which interferes with the absorption of the antibiotic. So Sanjay, never take tetracycline with a glass of milk. The combination makes the drug totally ineffective.
Certain food-drug combinations can kill. Drugs for depression containing monoamine oxide inhibitors cannot stand a substance called tyramine present in some foods. The combination pushes up blood pressure to dangerously high levels, resulting in severe headaches, brain hemorrhages, and even death.
Foods that contain tyramine include processed cheese, sour cream, curds, soya sauce, broad beans, bananas, and active yeast preparations. Sanjay, those who are prescribed monoamine oxidase inhibitor based drugs should also not touch cola beverages, coffee, chocolate and raisins.
We don't suspect it, but several drugs can cause vitamin deficiencies. Antibiotics, for example, kill the helpful bacteria in our intestines which synthesize many B vitamins. That is why a person prescribed antibiotics is also asked to take B-complex tablets. Our familiar remedy for pain and fever, aspirin, increases the loss of vitamin C from the body. This means that you must be careful to eat plenty of fresh fruits such as guavas, amla or citrus fruits, even if you are taking aspirin.
Oral contraceptives can cause several vitamin deficiencies, particularly the deficiency of vitamin C and folic acid. A good diet including fruits, vegetables, in particular the green leafy vegetables, can prevent this.
If you are taking any sort of drugs, it is best to avoid alcohol. You will be amazed at the number of drugs with which alcohol interacts. Here the problem is that alcohol often increases the effect of the drug. This can become a matter of life and death.
Take the tranquilizers and drugs that are used to counter depression. Together with alcohol, they cause excessive drowsiness and inability to do any work that demands mental alertness till the effect wears off. An overdose can even kill a person.
So Sanjay, try to learn all about the drugs which are prescribed to you. Avoid taking more than one drug at a time. And try to eat a nutritionally balanced diet.
Thank you, Sadhna and Rashmi, for your valuable advice. Next week, I'll meet both of you in good health.
were listening to a program entitled Food and Drugs. The participants were Sadhana Srivastav, Rashmi Kumar, Charu Gargi and Sangameshwar Rao. Scripted and produced by Sangameshwar Rao. This program was brought to you by Indira Gandhi National Open University.